Posse's the mole, there's gotta be some kind of sabotage.
Your mission, players, is a bank heist. Now, the first thing I'm gonna need you to do is pick the two players among you who are the best critical thinkers.
I think Kazi and Pranav would balance each other out. I like your selection.
All right, we are in. We have three key rings, and we have a ton of, like, lock boxes.
Does she have any clues for us?
I was gonna say, do you have any clues for us on your end?
I have a logbook.
What are the last names like?
We're close to nothing.
First lockbox, junk. Second one, junk. Third one, nicer junk. Fourth one, junk. Fifth one, junk, 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 junk.
It's gotta be a name that means stuff, or we're gonna keep finding trash.
It's just so frustrating. We just couldn't figure out how to move forward. What did we miss?
We have zero gold nuggets. What happened?
There was so many keys and so many boxes that there had to be something in our paperwork that would have allowed us to know which 10 it was.
I can tell you that there were names on the list that had associations with gold.
Oh my God.
What were the names?
K. Midas. King Midas. G. Locks. Goldie Locks. L. Dorado. Mythical City of Gold. If you had opened those boxes, you would have struck gold. One team will gather the mail by rail, a task that requires nerves of steel.
Posse's a team player in that she'll go where the group tells her to go, but once she's there, she pretty much drops the ball. If Posse's the mole, there's gotta be some kind of sabotage.
Come on, bitch.
It was awful. That feeling of letting your team down, but no, it was a complete accident.
Three of the backpacks contain 10K. So that is a possible $30,000 for your prize pot.
Wow.
However, not all of you are going to make it to the end of this climb. And the mole has decided which three of those backpacks have cash and which backpacks have precisely $0. As a group, choose two players to sit out immediately.
I'll do it because I feel like maybe I don't have the money in my bag.
So do you want to stay here?
Okay.
Let's see what you got, girl. Moment of truth. 10,000 or not? Oh! It was Kazi all along. In your next mission, you will be chained together, possibly all night.
Wait, what?
Oh.
Wow. Here is what's gonna happen. In this cage, there is a key, and that key will unlock all of your padlocks. Every 10 minutes, the cage will open, and one player will have exactly 1 minute to grab the key and free themselves from your chain gang.
We can do it.
In this cage, next to the key, there is something else that you may be very interested in. An exemption. If anyone does take the exemption, the challenge will stop immediately and the group earns no money. And everyone left here will sleep here on the floor.
What do you guys think? It opens every 10 minutes.
So yeah. We gotta move. Okay.
First.
We gotta figure out who's gonna go first.
How about Kazi?
Will.
I said Jacob.
I say Kazi. Get it, girl?
Go, Kazi! Woo-woo! Starting us off strong.
This is the easiest 20 grand, y'all.
$20,000.
Kazi was very skillful at taking you guys off the scent, but there were clues about the identity of the mole that were hidden in plain sight. Little Easter eggs everywhere. Joy,
In the jungle, do you remember what was on the side of the plane? There was a flag. Do you remember what that flag was?
No.
Let's have a look.
Hey guys, what's up?
Hey.
How are you guys doing? I'm Pranav.
Nice to meet you, Avery.
I'm
Avery.
Joy.
Nice to meet you too. So we know we have to find a plane. Here's the plane.
Yeah. Here it is.
It is the flag of Colombia, the country. What's the importance of Colombia, Cassie?
Colombia is where I went to undergrad.
And 06160.
That's my height and my weight.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
Thought that was kind of strange.
There were more clues in the outback. In a whiskey bar.
Team broke.
Team broke.
Kentucky bourbon.
Established 1994. What happened in 1994?
Your girl popped out.
Yes! Looking super cute, I'm sure. A lot of things are made in Kentucky. Bourbon and apparently Armol. You guys remember that delicious lunch you had where there was a bomb in the center of the table in the middle of the Merri Valley? Let's take a look at that bomb again.
Oh my gosh.
What?
There is a lot of cash on this table.
422-76.
That's her zip code.
Oh. Well done.
I can't believe it.
There were more clues on the side of a pizza box.
Oh my God.
Let's see.
As well as phone numbers, just for the record.
Can you see anything?
There's a bunch of bird feet around me and a pizza box.
Does it say Bill and Tony's?
Yep.
So we're at Bill and Tony's.
Excuse me, miss.
Yeah.
Am I allowed to see your pizza boxes there?
Sure.
Thank you.
Okay.
1994, 10/14. October 14th, 1994.
That's her birthday and year.
I would have never seen that.
Alex, we're
guys,
idiots. We get it.
Guys.
Yeah, well, right.
Those were subtle clues, and you had to have your eyes trained on one person in particular to really probably pick up on them. At the end of the day, you got by for a very long time evading people's radars. To the very end.
She was so convincing. I definitely owe her a thank you for being a shithole mole.